Joining us now in the studio with more on the terror along the Gaza border is Middle East expert from the Begin-Sadat Center at Bar-Ilan University, Dr. Mordechai Kedar. Thank you for joining us.
Nice to see you, Natasha.
All right, so let's talk about these incendiary kites and balloons. Why are Gazans turning to this method of warfare?
Well, after they failed in everything else, in the tunnels and the projectiles, and everything failed, so now the only thing which they have is this. However, the question is, why do they do this? To begin with, in the West, if you want to prevail, you study, you develop, you go forward, and you become better. In the East, in order to prevail, you destroy the others, rather than promoting yourself. And this is actually what they do. In order to promote themselves, they try to destroy us, to burn us, to kill us, and the whole thing. This is a different mindset, because this is the Middle East, and this is the problem.
All right, well, I mean, there's obviously an issue with how Israel is supposed to be responding to this, because nobody has actually been killed by these, you know, kite arsons, but it's been damaging a lot of land, and obviously there is the threat that somebody could get hurt here. Can lethal force be used in this situation, and is it smart for Israel to use that tactic?
Look, it is all connected to the rules of the game, and the rules of the game can be announced. The rule could be one kite equals a projectile, a missile, and we will answer a kite just like we answer a projectile. Why? Because this could kill. Because if it falls on some house and burn it, people might get burned to death. And this is why this should be the rule. And the same thing which we use, the same methods which we use, like personal targeting against those who send projectiles, should be implemented here as well.
Now, the United States has just left the Human Rights Council at the United Nations, but what effect do you think that this is going to have on the Israeli-Palestinian conflict, especially with what we're seeing take place in the Gaza Strip?
Well, if more countries will leave this council, this will have an impact, because don't forget that today, the United States of America under this administration is viewed as some kind of strange country. It lives here, it lives there, the JCPOA with Iran. So nobody really gets too excited if this government or this administration leaves any organization. If it becomes a phenomenon when other countries like Britain, like France or others will leave the Human Rights Council as well, this might have a very, very significant effect.
All right, Dr. Mordechai Kedar, thank you for joining us.
Thank you so much.